Some books, which means that that is the perfect excuse to record a video about it. And I'm happy to say that some of them I got in an actual bookstore. It's been a while. I think I could spend hours browsing bookstores and getting books and then going back to the shelves to put those books back. But in all seriousness, I love the serendipity of bookstore finds. However, there were some books that I could not find in the stores, so I ordered those online. So the first three books I got in the science fiction bookstore in Stockholm. And the first one that I want to talk about is Strange Beasts of China by Yan Ji. And I was very happy to find this one in the store, actually. I already talked about it in a previous video because my timing, recording and putting videos together is a bit weird these days. But in any case, this one is a difficult one to categorize in a single genre. I think it's best described as a mix of mystery and magical realism. The story takes place in the city of Yongan, where beasts and humans coexist. Some beasts are feared, some offer refuge, some others are a commodity. And each chapter is devoted to the study of these different species, and we get to know more about them and the main character of the story through the different stories that she writes. But if you want to know more about this book, feel free to check out my other video. The next book is Mythopedia by Good Wives and Warriors, and as the title suggests, this is an encyclopedia of mythical creatures and beings. The book is broken down into different sections according to world settings, so each section is devoted to a specific continent, and I really love how much it packs in such small size. Flipping through the pages of this book, I saw some of the most well-known creatures, but also some lesser-known that I had no idea about. And well, it has these beautiful and vivid illustrations, and that's the main reason why I got this book, because I recently got back into drawing and watercolors, and I thought that studying some of these illustrations would be a fun and probably very hard challenge. The next one is one of those rare bookstore finds. This is Ambiguity, Machines and Other Stories by Vandana, Singh. She's a science fiction writer from India, and I got this book because the stories seem to be centered around how humans move through time and space, so it looked like the kind of philosophical science fiction that I enjoy. I have been reading some of these stories already, as you can probably tell, and I have to say that it's been a bit of a mixed bag for me, and I guess that's bound to happen with short story collections. But so far, it's been an interesting blend between science and myth, and the author uses that to put forward some unique ideas about identity and how we struggle to make sense of our place in the universe. Yes, I am predictable. I also wanted to read the new Sally Rooney book. I read Conversations with Friends and Normal People. I enjoyed the latter more. I don't know, there is something about Sally Rooney's writing, her rawness and awkwardness, that really pulls me in. It's definitely not the characters, because at least in previous books, they always come across as a tad pretentious. But anyway, this book seems to follow a very similar pattern, with a bunch of young adults navigating through life in their 20s or 30s, I suppose. So yeah, I don't have a lot to say about this book because I'm still very early in, but I am really enjoying it more so than her two previous books. I have really tried to stay away from any reviews, so we'll see. The next one that I have is Cloud Atlas by David Mitchell. I've been meaning to get my hands into this book ever since I read The Cat and the City by Nick Bradley. This one obviously is one of the most well-known books by this author, I think. There's also a movie adaptation, I might see that afterwards. And all I know is that it's this epic science fiction story featuring interconnected stories. Now, I don't know if the fact that I know that it's a bunch of interconnected stories takes away from the enjoyment of the book, but I'm still very much looking forward to see how different characters and stories intertwine. Now for something completely different. This is The Beast Player by Nahoko Uehashi. And this is technically YA fantasy. And I got this because I know that eventually I will be in the mood to read something that is fast-paced. So this is a sort of escapism option for me. The synopsis reads a lot like typical YA fantasy, where we have the main character with these extraordinary powers that she discovers and that allows her to communicate with these magical beasts, and some way or other she finds herself in this quest to save the beasts and save herself. So yeah, whenever I find myself in a mood for something easy and fast-paced, I will definitely pick this one up, because I have tried to do this in the past, but I always end up reading dark and slow-paced books. So that's the end of the list we finally got here. So these are the 6 books that I recently got and that I'm very much looking forward to get into. If you have any recommendations, feel free to let me know, because I'm always happy to add more books to my to-be-read pile. Thank you for watching until the end. Please consider subscribing if you want to see more bookish content, and I'll see you in the next one.